Hi, how can I help you?
Yeah, hi. This is Michael Duncan. I'm calling to figure out where we're at with my 85 K5.
Oh, yes, sir. Give me just a moment here. Let me check on everything.
All right.
Michael?
Yes.
Hey, bud. How are you doing today?
Hanging in there? Yeah, we've got a million one things wrong, and just work's piling up, man. I'm hoping that we could get this thing finished.
Yeah, I know. So the part where we're at here is I had to drill that out completely. That bolt was just completely seized in there. So I drilled it out completely. The helicoil kit that I got would not torque correctly, so I had to order a special helicoil kit. They were one that actually stakes into the block there, so we'll actually cut threads into it and thread the helicoil into it and then thread the bolt into that, just because that is the main bearing there, and I have not received the kit yet. I ordered it about a week and a half ago, and I will check today and see where it's at. I checked on Monday, and it was still in transit. So that's where I'm at right now. I'm just waiting on that helicoil kit.
All right.
I have everything else here, man. I got it drilled out. I got, you know, and like I said, you know, the regular helicoil kit just would not hold. As soon as I went to torque down the bearing cap, it just pulled that helicoil right out of the engine. Dude, your top priority as soon as I get that thing in here, man.
Alright. Well, how are we on anything else? Like, are we able to work on trying to get the wiring unscrewed up?
Quite a bit of that on the inside there. I still have to change the stereo over to the other side, but I found, you know, a number of shorted wires and a bunch of just, you know, twisted wires twisted together, stuff like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I do.
I've done quite a bit there, but yeah, that's where my focus is getting this put on here. Cause as soon as I can do that, I can put the, you know, the whole bottom together, throw the exhaust on, you know, everything else is on there, you know, the intake's on, everything else is there. Also the throttle body, kind of where the throttle linkage and stuff comes around, whoever installed it, it kind of, you know, just rigged it up there. So I cut some piping, little tubes, so that it'll actually hold the correct space, because the I'll show you, but you know, the spacers that he used was just like a bunch of nuts and bolts and stuff.
Okay.
And it was slid on there, and the throttle was not actually like square to to the throttle body.
Okay.
But I'll show you that too.
All right.
Another thing that I've worked on there, and I know, man, it's killing me, dude. I want this thing out of here. You know, I want it running good and out of here. And just little things like this have just been jacking me over. I was really worried about, you know, that we were going to have to pull the whole engine and send it to a machine shop to have him, you know, re-thread the block or to drill it out and put a larger diameter in there.
Yeah.
But then I found this, I was talking to this machinist, and he was telling me about this other kit. It's like a helicoil, but it's from a German manufacturer, and he swears by them, man. He said they're, you know, they use them on like on big Caterpillar diesels and stuff.
Okay.
He uses them on I'm trying to think of the name of it. It's the Ingersoll Rand air compressors and stuff.
Yeah.
And you know they hold outrageous amounts of pressure, so you know that, there's no reason that this shouldn't fix it. You know.
All right.
So, all right, man.
All right, thank you.
Yep, thank you.
Yep,
sorry for taking so long. You have a good day. Goodbye.
I mean, you know, I mean, it's like you can appreciate people. They're trying to do the job, and they're trying to do the job right, and they're trying to put out a correct product. And if nothing's coming in, nothing's coming in. Part of the living in this part of the world, you know, got to learn to be some degree of self-sufficient, but. Daggone. All right.